So let's say I've got this homepage and I want to make it private and then have a login page with a one-click login with Google button. So first thing I have to do is actually add the Supabase Auth plugin. So going here, I will go to my project in the settings. So here in the API, take the URL, paste it here. Then the public API key, it's this one here, and the private one, it's this one here. Then I will define the redirection when the user is not logged into the login page. And for the role tables, I will take roles and user roles. Now I will go to the Google Cloud Console and go to new project. Actually create a new project that I will call demo and create it. Now that I selected this project, I will search for OAuth. Consent screen and credentials. So I will begin with the consent screen. So this is actually the screen that will appear to the user when they want to sign in your app. So I will select external. Then I will call the app demo. I use my email as the support email. Then for the logo and homepage, I don't need this, but for the authorized domain, I will add multiple ones. So the first one I need to add is obviously WeWeb, because your app is hosted on WeWeb. Then the WeWeb dash preview to be able to use the preview while publishing here without a domain. Then if you have a final domain, you should use it here too. I don't have one, but if you're using like your own domain, be sure to add it. And the last one is the one from Supabase. So I will use this one. So and then I will add the developer contact information. So 9. Save and continue. Don't need any scopes, because here we're just using the login. But if you want to add scopes, for example, using the Google Calendar, for example, or Drive, you will need to add them here. No test users. And back to dashboard. Then I will need to create credentials that I will share to Supabase from Google to be able to link them both. So, So credentials. And I will create new credentials using OAuth client ID. Then the application type is obviously a web application. So for the authorized redirect URIs, I will need to go back in my Supabase project, inside OAuth, then providers. I will add Google, and you see here, you've got the callbacks URL. So that's the one I will need to add here and create my client ID. Now I've got my client ID, a client secret that I will copy paste back to Supabase and save and enable the sign in to Google. Oops. And save. Now we'll need to tell Supabase where to redirect you when the authentication is done. So in URL configuration, still authentication, I will add my website URL. So it's the one here. Be sure to change this to your actual domain when your app is done. And then for the redirect URLs, I will redirect to the login page. So this one here. Now I need to go back to my WeWeb app, on my login page, on my login button, add a workflow, and I will select the action login with provider, select the Google provider, and redirect to the homepage here. And now if I test in preview and I click on this button, I'm redirected back to my Google OAuth page, and back to my WeWeb app. And you see I'm on the homepage, and if I go to the variables, I see my user and I'm authenticated. So that works.